Hi guys, hope you are all well. So today we're going to be talking about rosehip oil, its benefits and the different ways in which you can use it. And I'm really happy to be doing this video today because I promised to do this a very long time ago. So yeah, super happy to be finally getting around to it. Also, it's exciting to talk about because it has some very high profile fans. Miranda Kerr, Rosie Huntington-Whiteley and even the Duchess of Cambridge are all said to be fans. So rosehip oil, or as it's sometimes called, rosehip seed oil, as the name suggests, comes from the seeds of rose hips, and it's harvested from the rose bushes predominantly grown in Chile, and then through an extraction process the oil is separated from the seeds. Rosehip oil is rich in vitamins, antioxidants and essential fatty acids, and it's been used for thousands of years. The ancient Egyptians, the Mayans and Native Americans have been using rose hips and their oil for many years for their healing properties. The oil is rich in essential fatty acids, as I mentioned, but more specifically oleic, palmitic, linoleic and gamma linolenic acid. It's also rich in beta carotene, vitamin C and vitamin E, which are all antioxidants and great for the skin. One of the reasons that rosehip oil is so popular is down to its anti-aging benefits, and this is due to its high antioxidant content and also its ability to easily absorb into the skin, where it can improve moisture levels and also reduce the signs of aging. The high levels of vitamin C in rosehips could potentially help stimulate collagen production in the skin. Some studies of topical application of vitamin C actually induce significant collagen production. Rosehip oil has been termed by some as liquid Botox, down to its skin rejuvenating properties like vitamin C, vitamin A and lycopene, which can help repair the skin's surface and also promote elasticity. The antioxidants found in rosehip oil, particularly vitamin C and E, can help combat free radicals, which can lead to sun damage of the skin. But it's important to point out that it does not offer any protection from sunburn. These antioxidants can help reduce overpigmentation of the skin and therefore even skin tone. And there are anecdotal claims, at least, that it can help hyperpigmentation and even age spots. The essential fatty acids in rosehip oil could also help the appearance of scars and stretch marks, and again, there is anecdotal claims to support this. Rosehip oil is a very effective emollient, so it could help if you have eczema, dry skin or dry scalp conditions. It also has anti-inflammatory properties, so it potentially could soothe irritated skin. The colour of rosehip oil ranges from yellow to a deep amber, even with a reddish tinge. Now, generally speaking, the more yellow the oil is, the more refined it is. So you really want to be going for a less refined oil to get all the nutrition benefits. Rosehip oil also has a relatively low comedogenic rating of 1. So if you are worried about breakouts, it is one of the oils that is less likely to break you out. But as always, with any product that you're using on your skin, for the first time, I would recommend doing a patch test just to check that it's right for you. So how can you use rosehip oil? Well, you can use it in very similar ways to some of the oils I've already mentioned in previous videos, but we'll start with the ways that you can use it on the face, the hair, and then also the body. So first of all, you can use it very, very simply as a face oil, just for that extra kind of nourishing and moisturizing effect. Just a couple of drops will be enough for your entire face. A lot of the time when people complain about oils feeling super greasy is that they've just applied too much. Honestly, 2 to 3 drops would be enough for your whole face. I've also heard of people using rosehip oil as a specific, almost like a wrinkle treatment. And this would be a good option if you didn't want to kind of put oil all over your face. I've seen people using it kind of just on their lines here, maybe a little just here. And you know, just anywhere that you have lines that you're concerned about. Obviously, if you are going to use it near your eyes, please be really, really careful. Oil in your eye is not fun. You could also use it just in place of your regular moisturizer. You know, any product that is providing moisture to the skin is essentially a moisturizer. It doesn't need to be a cream to provide moisture. In fact, oils would be really, really good. A lot of people don't feel comfortable with that. But yeah, as long as you're not using too much, it should be perfectly fine in place of a regular moisturizer. Another thing you can do, again, if you're not confident with kind of putting oil all over your face, is if you take a little bit of your usual moisturizer, add maybe just a drop of oil into the moisturizer, mix that through, and then apply. You're kind of getting the moisturizer that you're comfortable with, but you're also getting sort of an extra emollient boost with the oil in there as well. If you like a really dewy look to your foundation, you can also add just a drop of oil into your foundation before you apply it. A lot of people really like what that does. They feel that it's really nourishing to the skin throughout the day and also gives them that kind of really glowy natural look. This is not something I do, as my skin is kind of combination to oily anyway, but if that's your bag, then you could definitely give that a go. You can also use rosehip oil as a remedy for dry lips. So you can just use maybe one drop and rub that into the area, or if you want to create an all natural lip scrub, if you take maybe a spoonful of brown sugar, a couple of drops of the oil, mix that together and apply to the lips. It works really, really effectively, and it's obviously all natural. You can also use rosehip oil as a makeup remover. I know some people prefer to use kind of cheaper oils to remove their makeup, but oils work so well to break down makeup, and it's a really cost-effective way of doing it. Some makeup removers are pretty pricey, especially if you're in kind of the clean beauty arena. They can be pretty expensive, and oil breaks it down really, really well. Again, just be careful around the eyes, you know, but it does work really, really well. Okay, so moving on to the hair. Well, you can use rosehip oil in the way that you would use any other hair oil, as kind of a deep conditioning treatment. So you would just apply to the hair, leave in for about 30 minutes or so, and then wash out. And it just provides that deep nourishing treatment that is so lovely. And it's going to be a lot cheaper than maybe going to the salon, and of course it's all natural. A lot of people think about argan oil for hair treatment, but I've experimented with several oils and most of them work really, really well on the hair. Secondly, you could also use it as a dry scalp treatment. So you would apply just to the scalp, massaging. That will help kind of lift any flakes of skin whilst also nourishing the scalp at the same time. So it can work really well in that way. And you can also use it a little bit like a hair serum. So one or two drops in the palm, rub it through your hands, and then just smooth over the hair, and that really, really helps flyaways. I've done this with various different oils and all of them work pretty well for that purpose. And then moving on to the rest of the body, you can use rosehip oil as a nail or cuticle treatment, just the same way that you can with lots of other oils. Just remember, less is more. You can also use it as a body moisturizer rather than using lots and lots of chemicals. Oils work beautifully on the skin. Again, less is more. A little goes a really, really long way. You do not want to feel like you have been in a chip pan. Just a really little amount really sinks into the skin and goes a really long way. You can also use a couple of drops in your bath water. This makes the bath feel so luxurious, so lovely. Just as with any oil, when you put it in the bath, just be careful when you get out, as it will make the water a little bit more slippery. But sometimes I find when you use bath oils, you don't even need to use a body moisturizer when you get out, because you're not stripping your skin by using, you know, maybe a sulfate-based bubble bath. It's nourishing the skin whilst you're in the water. And lastly, I've heard of people using rosehip oil as a cracked heel treatment. Now, it's not something I've tried, but I think I will give it a go. But if you do have cracked heels and you have some rosehip oil, why not give that a try? And if you do, let me know in the comments below if it worked for you. I would love to hear from you. So that is it from me today. I really hope this video was helpful and informative. And, you know, let me know if rosehip oil is something you use, if you enjoy, and if there's any ways that you use it that you think would benefit anyone else, please let me know in the comments. Thank you so much for watching, and I will look forward to seeing you on my next one. Bye now.